Let's have a go at casting a mini. Hey guys, if you saw my video last week, you'll have seen me putting the Elegoo 2 Pro through its paces and printing this fabulous mini designed by Archvillain Games. This is actually Dr. Jekyll, and there's something that really grabs me about this little fella. For something so small, and remember it's just 40mm tall, it's absolutely packed with detail, from the colour of his jacket to the buttons on his boots. I love this little guy so much, I just had to have a go at casting him in bronze. Folks do keep writing to me, saying that they're having trouble getting their prints to stick to the build plate. This happens particularly when using specialty resins. Now, I adore my new Phrozen Sonic 4K, but it still gave me trouble printing with Bluecast X10. I used the usual technique of sanding the plate flat using 80 grit paper on top of a few mirrors to ensure a very flat surface, and then I printed a prime coat. Now, Bluecast supplied their own prime coat, and I'm not talking about that. I still use that, it's an absolute must. But in addition to this, I also print my own prime coat, and this is a technique I have shared with you before. My theory is that this thin but wide print has a very large surface area, and this sucks itself to the plate. However, I've adapted this technique a little bit now, and I now incorporate my prime coat at the chitubox stage. With my print supported and ready to go, I simply open my prime coat file and position this in the build area. All of the printable items are on the same level, so when chitubox slices them, it incorporates them all into one print file. So all I need to do at that point is double the time of the bottom layer count. Straight off the printer, you can hardly see the prime coat is there, but I strongly believe this prime coat makes a massive difference when using Bluecast or other specialty resins. So when you next see this on other YouTube channels, remember you saw it here first. Not great camera work, I know, but this is positioning wax. It's sticky stuff that will hold the mini to the base nicely. You can ignore the ring, it's a little project my son and I are working on for his girlfriend. well, that looks pretty good. This bronze oxidizes, so it needs a 10 or 15 minute boil in ordinary water with a spoonful of citric acid. I'm really pleased with that. This is the smallest miniature I've cast so far, and credit has to go to Archvillain Games for such a great design. And before anyone asks, no, it's not for sale, and I won't be selling any. This is purely for personal use, and if you're looking for great castings, getting them via minis like these is a great way to do it. But the emphasis here, guys, is on personal use. Selling them requires the permission of the creator, in this case Archvillain Games. So if you fancy a sideline business like that, make sure you get proper consent first, otherwise it might end up costing you a lot more money than you'll ever earn from it. But we're not worried about that sort of thing here, guys. We're just here for the beauty of the bronze and the great looking mini. And look at those details. You can even see the buttons on his boots. It's truly amazing what you can do at home with castable resin and a 3D printer. I hope you enjoyed this casting quickie, guys. Take care and thanks for watching.